the presentation. Thank you.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. My name is Ono Purbo. I will talk about online teaching and experience art and culture during coronavirus and beyond. Thank you very much, Bu Nuning, and all the organizers of the art conference to allowing me to talk on this conference. To be honest, my background is not an artist. I am an engineer by training. So I will not talk about the art itself, but I will talk more on the platform or the technology that we can use for online teaching and experiencing art and culture during the social distancing because of the coronavirus. Okay. This paper can be downloaded from this website, onocenter.or.id. You can click publication here, and you can download the paper, the online teaching and experience art and culture during coronavirus from this website. Okay, so it's available online. I will talk about three major focus in this talk. First, from the user point of view, not from the artist, from the user, how can we visit museum, galleries all over the world from home. So from the user, for as well as how can we listen or discuss with the actual artist online. Okay. So this is from the user point of view, and then I will talk about the post-pandemic teaching, how we can teach art using the online course platform or doing some hybrid activity between online and hybrid means from with online and course and talking to the actual common people on the internet. So the formal course and the informal community environment. Okay. So the post-pandemic teaching, we will likely to see like that kind of hybrid between the formal and informal, okay? And the last one is the technology. How can we embrace technology for virtual gallery exhibition and art experience, okay? Of course, the pandemic force us to do physical distancing. So physical distancing is a growing reality. We cannot escape from physical distancing. So sooner or later, we have to do many of these things online, basically. Okay. The important things. So in the past, we can enjoy bloom of art activities across all media, performance, visual art, movie, and so on. But now, we have different ways we can do a cultural and artistic participant from our couch while sheltering in place. Okay, so in experiencing art and culture, we can visit galleries or museum all over the world from home. We can become a virtual group trotters to see exhibit art and learning materials over 1,200 museum worldwide with Google Art and Culture. This is the important one. Of course, there are other example, but this is so big. So Google Art and Culture is so big. We can see their website. This is their website, Google Art and Culture. You can zoom many things here. You can download even from Google Play and App Store. Okay, you can look for games, places, museum, artwork. We can explore these things and many things here. You can zoom in to art project, art filter, and so on. Okay. Now, maybe we are more interesting in enjoying something nearby to us. So there is a nearby menu here in artandculture.google.com. I will click nearby. So this is nearby of my place. Okay. So this is in Jakarta. You can see in North Jakarta we have some several arts or galleries in Central Jakarta, Tangerang and so on. I will go to the Indonesian National Museum. Okay. We can click here. We can view in Google and art and culture. This is how it looks like, but the important menu is this one. The small yellow guy here. Wow, this is another art is passing me. Sorry, I need to pause. Okay, sorry for the background music. This is the local art music musician. They are passing my presentation. So you are interested in the little yellow guy over here, we can click this so we can view the actual art in the actual environment. We can click one of them and then we can move forward and see how the exhibition looks like in the museum. This is 3D, we can do some virtual tour here. Okay, so this is the example of Google art and culture platform here. Of course, we need to coordinate with Google if we want our gallery goes into their maps and do some virtual exhibition like this. Okay. I don't know how much we have to pay. I think some of them are actually free. Okay. Now, in addition to the, in addition to the virtual visit to museum and galleries, social distancing is actually allow us to interact with the art school, see their digital thesis, follow art school social media account, and also the interesting thing is we can hearing podcasts, especially for artists, or YouTube broadcast. Some of the current favorite is the MAD curator Kimberly Drew about art and radical accessibility, for example. Okay, let's see. This is the search result for podcast curator Kimberly Drew. You can click here in Podcast Apple and then we can play and hear what she's saying. Okay, I stop. You can always hear it if you like. Okay, in on YouTube you can see the same thing here. You can find a lot of her lecture here. This is one of her lecture. This is in January 9, 2020 on YouTube, and you can listen on her lecture. Okay. So you can interact basically with many artists, with many curators on art all over the world, on podcasts, on YouTube, and everything. Okay, so that's from the user point of view. From the school point of view, of course, in normal school point of view, we can use the massive online, open online course. Okay. Massive open online course is quite normal for many schools now. We use Moodle mostly for this kind of thing. I'm sure at the art school at ITB they have Moodle also running for their courses. For other school it's very easy to install actually, but if you don't have the capacity to install one, you are welcome to use my not massive, we have a free e-learning platform at lms.onocenter.or.id/Moodle. You are welcome to use it. We have 40,000 students in this platform right now. We have 700 courses for free. Okay, so you are welcome to use this thing. But in reality, the teaching process is actually blending, merging between the formal course and informal interaction with the community outside the school environment. Okay, so the blending process can be can be as to get creative and build community. For example, one of the example this is art archive challenge. You can see the art archive challenge in Instagram, or they have their own website actually. Show you a little bit what this. This is their website. You can search on Google and you will find the artworkarchive.com. This is their website. This basically interaction between the real art professionals and the art enthusiasm. They can share work and so on, and they have competition. They have contests on Instagram, okay, on art. Okay, this is some of the results. You can check on Instagram. This is the Instagram on Artwork Archive. This is the artwork they have put. This is put by many people. Okay, on Instagram. Of course, in addition to get creative and build community, some galleries, some museum actually set up a hashtag. For example, this is Museum Moment of Zen hashtag. Firstly posted by Museum of City of New York, and is now used by many museum to attract people or to tell people about their collection. You can check on Twitter, on Instagram, and so on. So this is, I checked the hashtag Museum Moment of Zen on Twitter. And this is some of the museum was actually posting. This is only 6 hours ago in the Wendy Museum. Okay, this is some of the this is High Museum of Art. This is Jetty Museum. This is Westfield History Museum. So many museum. So they are putting their collection, sample of their collection, on Twitter, on Instagram. That way people knows what's inside the museum. So this is how the communication built among between the museum and the community or the artist itself, himself, sorry. Okay, of course you can use other keyword for finding art. For example, I use modern art keyword on Twitter. You can find a lot of things on modern art, which is quite amazing. Okay, so that's how we interact. Okay, now let's go to the more practical tools. You have several options for practical tools. There are two people I like to mention here. That is Rega Octaviana. Octavian Rega at gmail.com. He is a graduate student in art department at ITB. In his past time, he actually built the Cube Virtual Space. Okay, this is how it's look like, the Cube Virtual Space. I have to go to my my folder. Okay, FSRD. This is his video on the Cube Virtual Space, so people can go inside the virtual space, exhibition space basically. An artist can put their exhibition, their results, their product, their artwork in this space, and we can look. We can enjoy their product, their artwork from here. Okay. Interestingly, this is made by an art student, so anyone can build these things actually. Okay. The second one is Muhammad Ari Kurniawan. His background is game programming. He's my son's friend, and he actually built this one. Okay. He actually worked for real estate company for exhibiting their houses. So no voice, no audio. So we can go here and go here, and we can actually go inside the house. Let me go inside the house, enter sorry, enter the house here. So we can, so it's very similar to art gallery, but this is for houses. But you can put a lot of details here. You can this is only television, but actually you can put any artwork here, put it in close up, in details, so people can enjoy how it looks like. Okay. This is made by Indonesians, Ari Kurniawan. Okay. Now, the other tool we are, I have to stop this one. Okay. The other tools you can view in the paper, there are quite a lot of tools we can use. Some of them actually free and open source. Space 3D, for example. This is open space 3D. We have option to download the software for free. Okay, so you can download the open space 3D for free. The problem is you need to have some programming, sort of programming ability to use these things. Okay, the other one is also open source, this one. So there are two open source application. This is Marzipano 360 Media Viewer for Modern Web. It's free. You can download on GitHub. This is some of the demo. So you can enter here, for example. So you can look around. There is a pointer here. So you can enter the exhibition. You can look around here. And you can enter another exhibition. You can look around here, enter another exhibition to look around. So basically, it's available, the source code, and you need to put up the picture, the graphics, and so on. Okay. The other one is the rest is mainly they call it free, but they are looking. You have to pay later. Sooner or later, you need to pay. Otherwise, for example, if we want to have more feature, we want to be more attractive and so on, we need to pay. So there is pricing. This is La Pentor. Okay. This one interesting. Make VT. We can create virtual tour here. Oops, okay, virtual tour like here, like this, too fast, okay, like this, okay, this is Make VT, this one is Vtility, okay, same thing, we need to, the artists need to upload the pictures mostly, after pictures, upload some storytelling and so on, so we can do the same thing for real estate on Vtility. So we can do virtual tool, this is Infinity. Yeah, so a lot of things here. This is Art Steps. Several Indonesian has used this one, Art Steps. You can do a lot of interesting thing here. So also in California and so on. So that's the platform. So the artists need to upload mostly the storytelling, the picture and so on. But if you like to make the actual art on the computer 3D, there are several tools. These two are I have found two tools from Google, Tilt Brush. Basically, you can make 3D brush, 3D pictures on your computer. Okay. The name of the application is tiltbrush.com, and the other one is the poly.google.com, is for exploring 3D world. So we can build a 3D world and we can explore it. For example, this one. So we can build our own 3D world and we can explore, and then people can see the actual product in 3D. So this is not taking pictures of the physical product, we actually creating the product on computer, 3D product on computers. Okay, so that's some of the options we have for the end users, for the end user, visiting galleries, for the technology and the teaching process. And I hope it can give some idea on online teaching and experiencing art and culture during coronavirus and beyond. Thank you very much.
So thank you, Dr. Ono, about the for the presentation. It's also interesting to have a perspective the consumer, so from the point I could make a resume of first pandemic. The opportunity to visit precious places and events is usually quite difficult to visit a person like in person. Two, football. Second, enabling football in connection with various arts groups. The pandemic also enabled us to have a football connection with various art schools, creators, artists, those who are responsible, podcasts, YouTube, etc. And the third one is artists could also venture into these new art new platforms by going digitally. By doing online exhibition using various media to connect with the art collectors and also developers. Thank you.
Thank you.
How are you? Very interesting. Thank you.
Sorry, your sound is lit. I don't know. There is a problem on my network, I guess. The sound is not smooth enough.
Okay, thank you. Yeah. So I think we now can continue to our question and answer